Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William split broke the nation's hearts. So what was the devastating thing Kate was forced to accept about Prince William? Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William met nearly 20 years ago, when they were students at the University of St. Andrews in Scotland. Although they are the image of marital bliss now, with three beautiful children now part of the picture, they encountered some bumps in the road in the earlier stages of their relationship. Read on to find out the heartbreaking thing Kate was forced to accept about her relationship with the future king. Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William captured the nation's hearts at their glorious wedding ceremony in 2011. Since their marriage at Westminster Abbey, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge have since welcomed children Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis. But back in 2007, Kate and William's relationship reportedly hit a rocky patch. At the time, a friend told the Daily Mail Kate desperately wanted the prince to propose to her, but William believed all the fun was gone from their relationship. The friend said, as far as she was concerned, it wasn't a question of if, just when. She openly admitted that she expected a formal announcement to be made by Clarence House. Another source told the publication William simply wasn't ready to settle down with Kate at the time. And there was one thing Kate would be forced to accept by being in a relationship with the king-to-be. They said, he has always had a roving eye, far more so than Harry, who is meant to be the family playboy. That's something Kate has always known and accepted, it was part of the deal, if you like. I suppose in that respect, she would have made a perfect Princess of Wales. What has changed in recent months, however, is the way in which the public was starting to view Kate as a future princess. Kate and William's split only lasted for a few months, and the couple seemed to have gotten themselves back on track quite quickly. Kate and William announced their engagement back in 2010 and their turbulent past is now behind them. Princess Charlotte started her first day of school this week, and the couple were beaming as they walked their children to meet their head teacher. Meghan, Duchess of Sussex and Prince Harry married last year in their stunning royal wedding. Just under a year later, this May, the happy couple welcomed Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor to the royal family. The royal pair met 3 years ago, when they had a blind date in London during the summer of 2016, meaning that they will have marked their anniversary alongside other celebrations this summer, including the Duchess' birthday. Podcast Royals, from Australian magazine New Idea, heard from royal expert Angela Mollard on why the three-year mark will be crucial for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Ms. Mollard said, I've been thinking about this a lot, because 3 years is generally understood by relationship psychologists and counselors to be the point where you move out of the lime rents phase. She explained, lime rents is deeper than infatuation, but it's the beginning of a relationship where it's all butterflies and you laugh together all the time and you're very amenable. 3 years is around the stage where reality starts to kick in. She continued, now, they've hit 3 years at a point when they've had a baby. Their relationship has moved very quickly by necessity, if she wanted to have a baby they had to move quickly. Obviously they took a completely different approach to the Cambridges, who had a very long courtship. Ms. Mollard went on, it's that transition phase, to real life, with a baby, with the pressure of your jobs. There are a lot of conflicting forces within their lives. I think they have to have a marriage that is stronger than most. And, I think that's going to be very, very hard. They will have to work very hard with a lot of pressures that most people don't endure, to make sure that they focus on their relationship staying really strong. I know that Harry has had a lot of counseling in the wake of his mother's death, and I hope that they have the support around them to guide them through the next stage. Ms. Mollard also gave her opinion that Meghan had subtly hinted at the difficulties she may feel. She said, we've had the fairy tale, with the first tour, and everyone swept up in Meghan and Harry. We know from what Meghan said at the Lion King premiere, when she was talking to Pharrell Williams, when he commented on their relationship and how much of an inspiration they are. She was heard to say, they don't make it easy. Now, we don't know who she means by they, does she mean the public, the media. But, there was a first acknowledgement ever there, that it is hard, and it is challenging for them. She concluded, "The reason I think it's the make or break time, as I say, they're at the 3-year point in their relationship, they've had a new baby which is a pressure in itself, and they're in this invidious position where they are royal, but not royal, having ordinary lives? I'm hopeful, but I don't think it's going to be easy. It's hard enough for ordinary people."